If I don't pick up the sidewinder, sleep, sleep, sleep's little coil. Come and shall wake her up. Come and shall wake her up. Come and shall wake her up. Hello, welcome back to English Be Good. My name's Chris, and today we're talking about this great song by REM, which is a song that I could never really understand. And I actually thought the band were Irish because of the kind of the pronunciation and the way the chorus sounds. So this is the one where it kind of says, it's meant to say, call me when you try to wake her up. But it's more like kind of, Camlin shall wake her up. Camlin shall wake her up. For me, sounds like this kind of Irish jig. Anyway, let's go through the lyrics. They're not so clear. They're a little bit avant-garde. They're a little bit kind of experimental, poetic. So we have to interpret what we can here. Let's start from the beginning anyway. So this song actually is The Sidewinder Sleeps Tonight, is the title, right? The Sidewinder Sleeps Tonight. Better. And the Sidewinder, okay, it's, what is it? It's a telephone in this case, okay? It's one of those telephones that the cable winds around like this. So in English, for people who don't speak English natively, to wind is the verb when you, like a fishing reel, where you put the cable around something. And in this case, the way the cable of the telephone winds, it's like a snake called a sidewinder, which actually moves by across the sand, I think, in the desert by kind of curling itself. Hard to explain. Okay, so in the beginning, you hear him kind of wailing a little bit, Michael Stipe. And he's doing the kind of the in the jungle, the wild jungle. There's a little bit of a a similar kind of wail that you hear in that song. And actually, REM paid to clear the usage, paid the copyright to be able to use it. And I think they also recorded on a B-side of the single, a version of The Lion Sleeps Tonight, which is kind of also borrowing from the title, The Sidewinder Sleeps Tonight, The Lion Sleeps Tonight. So that's the reference. Just in case you never noticed, I hadn't noticed before, I must say. Anyway, so after the intro, you've got an F on the guitar. And it says, this here is the place where I'll be staying. To C. And there's a little kind of little bit on the C chord. Okay, this here is the place where I will be staying. So I imagine he is telling a friend, maybe showing a photograph, saying, this is where I will be staying in the future continuous. Okay, so just for those English learners out there, the future continuous because it's temporary, okay? I will be staying, not where I live permanently. Then he says, there isn't a number
you can call the payphone.
Okay, so it doesn't have a permanent telephone number, but there is a payphone, which is one of the old telephone boxes that you put money in, coins in, to pay. If you imagine my only reference, because obviously I'm English from the UK, I'm not American, so from the movies, I kind of imagine these New York apartments with a dusty old telephone at the end of the corridor that people share because maybe they don't have enough money or enough... well, let's imagine this song was written a long time ago as well, and not everyone... Well, nobody had mobile phones, so there you go. The old days when people had to use payphones, maybe. When I was at university, I didn't have a telephone. I needed to use a kind of communal phone, similar to this. Sometimes you have to wait in a queue to use the phone even. Okay, so then he says, so we just had, you can call the payphone, let it ring a long, 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 long time. Okay, so let it ring a long, long time. Perhaps here, because he's in his apartment, so you might not hear it, okay? He's got his door closed, and the phone is outside in the corridor, so you might not actually hear it. If I don't pick up,
hang up,
and then he goes, call
back, let it ring some more.
Okay, so if I don't pick up, hang up, call back. So we've got lots of phrasal verbs here. Pick up is to literally get the phone when you answer. Hang up is when you put it back down again. Okay, and this is call back, another phrasal verb. So call again, basically. Let it ring some more. Okay, so you're saying like be patient and wait for him. And then he says. Bit of wailing.
If I don't pick up, the Sidewinder sleeps in a coil.
Okay, this is pre-chorus. You can feel the tension and the build-up here. If I don't pick up, he repeats himself a bit. This is a nice rhythm to the way he sometimes stutters the lyrics, and he does this intentionally to give it a rhythmic feel. The Sidewinder sleeps in a coil. So the telephone is the Sidewinder. Sleeps, if you imagine it, yeah. You know, it's waiting to ring and it's sleeping until it wakes up and it rings. It's a nice analogy. Okay, then we have the... So the coil is like a spring for those people who don't speak English. Natives. Like a spring, basically, yeah, when it goes round and round. Okay, then we got the chorus, which is the most confusing, maybe the most confusing chorus in history. I don't think anyone can understand from listening to him. So I will, first of all, I will say what it's meant to be, okay? So it's, call me when you try to wake her up.
Call me when you try to wake her up.
Doesn't fit, does it?
Call me when you try to wake her up.
But in reality, I'm hearing
Charlie shall wake her up. Gambling shall wake her up.
Gambling. Some people say calling Jamaica, yeah. I'm like, calling
Jamaica, yeah.
There's lots of interpretations. Call me when you try to wake her up. Okay. Now, her so far has been the telephone. This is the pronoun we're using for a machine. And I've said this before, that sometimes we use pronouns, personal pronouns, that are designed for humans, but we use them to refer to things that we love, like or something we're affectionate about. Maybe your bicycle, favorite bike, or your car, or your a boat is often she. We might refer to it that way. Okay, so call me, like advise me, you know, on the telephone. When you try to wake her up. Now, if the her is the phone, it's going to be difficult to call. Call me when you try to call me. It's kind of, it doesn't make too much sense, does it? Now, maybe there is another person here and it jumps to her being someone else. I'm not too sure. I think it's like a kind of ironic thing of like, come on, call me. Try and call me, wake the phone up, give me a call, something like that. But write in your comments below what you think it means, because some of the other band members were asked about this and they said, well, some of it refers to a dream, which we're going to see in a minute. There's some kind of surreal moments, but generally it's a telephone that's a bit old and knackered. Knackered, by the way, for people, again, not non-English watches. Knackered means very old and worn out. Okay, so he repeats this chorus quite a lot. Charmeline shall wake her up, or call me when you try to wake her up. And then we move to the next verse, which is... So let's just finish the last bit. It goes kind of like... Let's do one little bit of the chorus again, just to get me in the groove. So,
come as you wake her up. Oh, there are scratches on
Can't sing it that high. There are scratches all around the coin slot. Okay, so the coin slot is where you put the money, the coins, the slot. And there are scratches because it's been used so many times.
Like a heartbeat, baby, trying to wake up.
Like a heartbeat, baby, trying to wake up. Okay, so I think comparing the maybe the sound of the telephone when it's when you pick it up and you hear the dial tone, it's kind of like flatlining, like a machine that monitors your heart. Okay, so, or is he comparing, I don't know, the heartbeat is also like the way it rings, like a beat, isn't it? It's like ding, 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 ding. I don't know. What do you think about that? It's a tricky one. Trying to wake up. No, maybe the telephone is a bit old and knackered. Well, we've just read that, haven't we? Because of the scratches. So it's trying to wake up because it doesn't really work that well, but it's kind of doing its best. And then he says, but this machine... No, hold on. Wake up. This machine can only swallow money. I didn't really sing that properly, did I? Let's get back into the groove. Like a heartbeat, baby, trying to wake up. But this machine can only swallow money. Okay. So, swallow, like, your food. A lot of the old telephones, the payphones, would break. You put the money in and then it wouldn't work. And it would drive you crazy, I remember. Then he's talking about fixing it. You
can't lay a patch by computer design.
Lay a patch is to fix something that's broken, like your jeans, or, you know, if you have a hole, you stick a patch on. Here he's talking about repairing the phone. Computer design. Yeah, so the modern inventions, everything is designed by computer. You can't just invent a patch and create it on the computer. You now probably can with 3D printers, but in those days you couldn't. And then he's quite critical, I think, of computers in the next line, because he says there's just
a lot of stupid sounds.
So I think it's all that. You know, this could be two things. For me, the computers have lots of symbols and signs, don't they, on the keyboard. This is generally how they kind of work. Or it could be that there are lots of symbols, no, sorry, lots of signs around the telephone saying it's broken or something. I don't know. Then he says, tell her. So let's get back into the groove.
Computer design is just a lot of stupid signs.
Oh, yeah.
Tell her.
Then he says,
tell her she can kiss my ass.
It's really hard to understand this in the lyrics, and it's also very hard to sing. Tell her she can kiss my ass. Okay, so is her the telephone? Maybe he treats it like a person, you know, and like if you speak to the phone or you try and call, tell her she can kiss my ass because we're very close. And then laugh, okay? Then
laugh and say that you were only kidding.
So I think, yeah, it's talking about the telephone. It's like this old telephone is a friend of Michael Stipe's. And if you speak to her, tell her that you were only kidding. And that way she'll know.
That way she'll know that was really, 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 really me.
Okay, so that way to recognize that the message has come from him. It's obvious, right? Okay, then we got a bit of a chorus again.
Jumping to wake her up. Call me when you try to wake her up.
Then we're going into verse 3.
Baby, instant soup doesn't really grab me. Today I need...
Okay, so let's stop there. Baby, in general, sometimes we say baby to people, no? We call them... Is he talking to his phone again? I think he's just speaking generally. Instant soup doesn't really grab me, so these are more indications that he lives in kind of a maybe a poor area, or he doesn't have much money. He's eating pretty cheap food, not great quality food. Instant soup doesn't really grab me. This expression means that it doesn't really kind of attract me, basically. Don't really feel like that. It's not attractive to me. Today I need something more substantial. Today I need, so it's baby, instant soup doesn't really grab me. I don't know if this is gonna fit. Today I need, I don't know how it fits it. Today I need something more substantial. Oof, that's really hard to sing unless you're in the groove, and even then it's hard because the words don't really fit into the music very well, which is why we can't really understand a lot of it when we're actually listening to the record. So we need something more substantial, something often we refer to like good food as being substantial, something that would be good for you. A can of beans or black-eyed peas, so Nescafe and ice. Okay, so some other types of food. Can of beans, he's not really elevating it too much. But beans are healthy. Black-eyed peas, a bit more healthy again. Some Nescafe and ice. Nescafe is pretty basic, simple powdered coffee, isn't it? It's nothing flashy. But with the ice, now he's splashing out a bit. It's a bit more sexy. So maybe it's summer as well, because he's having ice. A candy bar. A candy bar, a fallen star, or a ream from Dr. Zeus. Okay, so a candy bar, obviously it's American for like chocolate bar or some kind of sugary treat. A fallen star, falls from the... Okay, I don't know what a fallen star is. Maybe it's some kind of snack that you can get from... in America, or he's fantasizing, or a reading from Dr. Zeus. In the recording of this song, apparently they laughed because he couldn't pronounce Dr. Zeus. He kept on saying Zeus, like the Greek god. Now, Dr. Zeus is this author that wrote those crazy books like Cat in the Hat and stuff. Might have got that wrong, so there will be a correction on screen if I have. There's more about that later. Okay, then we've got the chorus again. Coming you wake her up. And so on. Now then, this is the bit where we got a little bit extra. We've got the B minor here. The cat. Okay, yeah. The cat in the head came back and raped a lot of havoc on the way. So, this is a book like by Dr. Zeus, or Seuss. Raped a lot of havoc. Typical expression to create a lot of chaos, which was typical in these books about the cat in the hat. Always had a smile, so we're back on that. Let's start again. The cat in the hat came back and wreaked a lot of havoc on the way. Always had a smile and a reason to pretend. Their world. Okay, so I had a smile, the cat was always happy, and a reason to pretend, have fun and be silly and creative. And I think Michael Stipe really loved his cartoons and this kind of surreal world of illustration, where especially this type of book that we're talking about by Dr. Seuss, because they were quite dreamlike and very free. And I think in this part of the song, he's asleep and he's dreaming. And maybe the telephone will wake up and consequently wake him up. It's my theory. What do you think? And then we've got a bit more. But their world has flat backgrounds, okay? But their world has flat backgrounds and they don't need to sleep. So in the cartoons, you don't need to sleep. They never sleep, do they? Hardly ever. But to dream... The Sidewinder sleeps on his back. Okay, so they just dream and express themselves in the cartoons. This is like a little fantasy of being free and liberated, I think. Now he refers to the phone again, which is asleep on its back, as in put on the top of the phone. Now, we've got a bit chorus again. And I think that might be it. Yeah, chorus until the end. Okay. So an interesting song. A bit surreal, no? Well, Dr. Seuss is surreal. And that features. It's, yeah, talking about a telephone that's kind of old and knackered. And affectionately. Sentimentally. Maybe because he relies on it a lot. And he kind of, even though it's a bit bad and broken, he actually likes it and has become attached to it. I don't know. Let me know what you think in the comments. Anyway, the most interesting thing probably about this song is the chorus, isn't it, and what it actually means. And it's funny how many artists will try and squeeze a load of lyrics into a small space like this. So we've got like, call me when you try to wake her up, just come to wake her up. Michael Jackson did the same, I think, with like Billie Jean. There's a lyric in that which is like, for me it sounds like the chair is not my lover or something, but he's saying kid. Anyway, interesting stuff. Now we're going to play through the song, which I've already prepared, and we'll sing along with it, and this will help us learn. For all you English learners out there, this will help you remember the language, hopefully the meaning, and then you'll get some of these expressions and it'll help you remember. Yeah. Okay, well, I'll be back soon. I'll be back at the end of the song to say goodbye. Let's get the guitar. Well, it's already here, but let's put ourselves into song mode.
Came back and wrecked a lot of havoc on
to little me, need to dream. The Sidewinder sleeps on his back. Camera's gonna wake her up. Camera's gonna wake her up. Camera's gonna wake her up.
And I did make a few little mistakes. But hey, I'm not on stage, am I? I'm just on YouTube. No big deal. Okay, back to the other guy. No. Thanks very much for watching today. It's been fun. Hope you come back soon to watch another video of mine. I'm going to try and find some more time to do some more songs and more interesting videos to help you with your English, and also to maybe give you a bit of info on what the meaning of the song is. So yeah, take care. And until next time, goodbye. I'm Chris and this is English Be Good. Bye.